What are our options? I just don't remember the name of the white land. So you've got secluded, that's you have to pay white for it, or there's the one that's too colorless, which might actually make more sense, which is not that one. It's the old school one. There it is, Meadow. Meadow might make more sense in this deck as Rotron. I can see a 1-2 of Drifting Meadow making a lot of sense. Early game, if you don't have a 1-drop, you just play it out. Late game, you would just cycle it. That's pretty sick. Bogles must be a great matchup then. It would be, because you just go turn 1, you know, turn 1 or turn 2 tutor, and then turn 3 you grab this, and you're like, well, guess we're sideboarding. Not sure about any crushers. We're not in blue. Be harder to find the right lands. Yeah, I mean, like, we don't need the crusher. We don't need crusher. We should be able to win on our little plucky guys. You don't necessarily need a crusher. I mean, maybe you'd want one crusher. Like, if you know there's going to be no permission, then crusher seems fine. Oops. Moral says, whoa, you can tutor. Yes, you can. Exactly. Oops. I got the other version. I want to test one crusher, maybe not main. Chaos says, no, you're one drop. Right, right, right. You're right. So you'd have to Ramosen. If you wanted to go Sergeant, you'd have to Sergeant into either Scout, Falcon, or Lieutenant. That's very true. And now that we're not splashing black, we have a little bit less consistency than the black version did, right? Because now I have fewer tutors. That's a thing. I mean, if you wanted to make your matchup against black, I mean, we could look and see how some of the two-color Tron decks pull it off. Pull off being multiple colors. They utilize things like this. Let me show you. I mean, Tamiratron might not be the best example, but that's one of the more popular ones. Isatron is also technically four colors, so take your pick. What does this one do? It utilizes a more colorful mana base. That's not what I was interested in looking at, though. I was interested in seeing how many... it runs a playset of Prophetic. Oh, absolutely not, Holmes. But you know what's funny is pretty much all of the tools I used to beat our last opponent, if you weren't here for that now, nope, that's not Holmes. Everything that I used to beat our last opponent is basically still here. The only thing that we've done is we've cut black and added, we didn't even use a single duress on that control player and still beat him. Easily. Sphere, Star, Prism, Filter lands. See, I don't even know if I want that. I feel like I still value a lot of these white-white, albeit I've moved some of them. And if you want to be a little more interactive, you probably want a 1-1 split Sun Lance. And then... you get either Wall or Gossamer. What makes more sense? This one's for protecting our dudes. This one is more for tempoing our opponent. I kind of prefer Gossamer Chains for that reason. They have different functions. Rhystic Circle seems really neat, though. We've got a lot for red. Why don't we actually axe the Thermal Glider and stick with the Acolyte? Oh, no, Thermal Glider's tutorable. That's true. This is really useful, though, potentially. Children in the side. Two Dust to Dust. Two Holy Light. Shield Bear, Corliss. Too many bears. Just one. Rhystic. Glider, Glider. Crusher, Acolyte. Ring, Ring. Second Lance. Yeah, we'll keep running the bodyguards. They're flexible. It doesn't really matter what color our opponent's removal is. You can always use the bodyguard. It's nice to have a turn one play when you don't have turn one Urza mana. You have turn one planes, which we'll have a lot of the time. A reasonable amount of the time. How many is this? 10? It might not be enough. Ten pins, why can't you be Popper? I know, right? We'll see if the Soul Charmer is what we need. So we get one more card. Yeah, pick something out of this. Prismatic Shards, apparently very popular in the weenie. Prevent all damage that sources the color of choice would deal. And it has flashback. That seems sweet. What else? I'd like to pick and choose between Doomsayers and the other. This one's the pinger that has applications. This one's the target creature gets -2/-0, whereas Doomsayers taps down small toughness. I mean, like, they have different applications, different board states they're useful for. I mean, I could give up my crutch that is Bodyguard, and that would give us a lot more space in the deck in general, if we wanted to do that, if you wanted to let go from that. And run a 2 of Crusher. Just have more late game. He's already here. That would give us a lot more space. You could, like, main some number of O-Ring. It's flexible enough, you can main an O-Ring, it's fine. And then same for Lance, there's plenty of aggressive decks being played. And then we get to run some of my kind of spice, Ward and Gossamer. I wouldn't expect anyone to play around Ward. I wouldn't expect anybody to do so. And then the last card I want for, we're already running it. Another sideboard card. The Vigilant Guy may be useful. Remember, without black, we lose the pinger. We have to go to the sky. We have to go to the air. Is Ristic main deckable? Think of the gem. More main deckable than Sunlands, maybe. That seems powerful. So the late game potential of the deck besides slamming a Crusher could just be Ristic Circle with a lot of mana online, couldn't it? Could it not? It could. I mean, without the bodyguards, the deck does feel a little more removal soft, though. That's all I'm going to say on that matter. I mean, that's the other way to build it. You could build the deck with some more tools, these four tools that I just added to the main deck, or make them all sideboard, and then you get the benevolent bodyguards again, then you have to cut some stuff from the sideboard. I think the children is actually really spice, but probably too cute. I am Vox. Yeah, I've got a Nightwing Glider and a Thermal. Potentially even main deck material. Like, you could do this. You could go, if you really wanted to have some spice, you could go main deck the Gliders and then grab them in the appropriate matchups and win. Well, not immediately, but... I mean, Ristic seems so powerful, though, game one. No offense to the Crushers. This seems just so powerful game one because they may not have their enchantment. They won't have their enchantment stuff in just yet. So the Ristic Circle just has a lot of potential to run away with the game one. We know we're already favored against control. We just played that matchup just off of the ability to just keep tutoring up threats they can't counter. Love Ristic Tron. Well, how expensive would this be to get us into... This seems powerful. This seems fun. I like tutoring every turn. By far, my favorite Pauper deck. Babe. basically says, don't be the guy who plays Ristig, you lose. Oh, maybe the first few times you play it. I mean, that was the case with some of the other complex, not necessarily complex in paper, but complex on Magic Online. Or just lots of triggers and clunky. Shadow, you know that doesn't scare me away. That might scare a lot of other players away. No, I'll totally play a deck that you have to learn and practice before you stop going to time. Sometimes it's worth it. Is that everything? So what's the super expensive part? The Holy Lights, right? We knew that was going to be expensive, but I mean, it's an instant non-white, everything non-white dies. So that seems worth the investment if we're going to actually play this deck. What else? Prismatic Shard, Strands is relatively expensive, way more expensive. We could hold off on that. This still makes more sense in like mono white weenie. I mean, we have a weenie component to us. We could hold off on the Strands until I fall in love with the deck. That would bring it down significantly. I was just going to have a one of in the sideboard anyway. That would save us two tickets for now. All right, let's play it. We'll find something else for that spot. I could run Embolden. That's like a budget alternative. Embolden is worse because you can't free cast it, but prevent the next four and then flash it back. It's fine. It fulfills a similar role of protecting multiple creatures. Alright, let's jam. Yeah, let's hit the practice room for a round or two before we take it to the league. What was the price? It was like two tickets for one Kron. Oh no, it was a little less than two tickets, but it would have taken two tickets to get it. Alright, Pauper Rebellion. I guess we gotta call it Trebellion, right? Trebek Trebellion. Pauper Trebellion. Rebels. It's a revolution. Play Red White Soul Sisters. Yeah, triggers.deck. Oh, hey, our hand works. We have two planes. Yay. Oh, but no tutor. Hmm. And double tower. Hmm. Hmm. Has tutor. Keep. Bottom. So you would lead Meadow. Affinity. Or well, there's a couple other decks that would go turn one splinter. Ooh. So do I lead? Ah. The choices. Mm. You know what? We top deck the Sergeant. And then we can play Meadow. I will just call it V for Vendetta. You can call it whatever you want. Think about some Pauper Bruce Day where take a shot. Blue black control decks centered around Ghastly Demise, Monarch Walls, Rats, Drifters, Grindy. Martyr deck with Bleak Coven, Vampire. Mm. That sounds sweet, man. You should do it. Yes, he's on like the Jeskai deck, right? So this isn't going to live, I imagine. Basic Swamp says Debt Plains. Who's mine? That is indeed a black spell. No! I can't believe it. You put